back to the book of 2 Samuel chapter number 9 and verse number 1. Back to 2 Samuel chapter number 9 and verse number 1. Amen. Hallelujah. Because the Lord is not done with us. Somebody give God praise wherever you are this morning. Amen. And if you can kindly minister to your neighbor and tell the neighbor, please neighbor, you cannot settle for less. Hallelujah. Because there's more that is found in the Lord. Amen. And that means there's more that is in the Lord, that is more that is in this world. Hallelujah. There's more that is found in this house. There's more that the Lord has to give in your praises of work. There's more that the Lord wants to do in your family. There's more that the Lord wants to do in your own personal life. Amen. So you cannot settle for less. The Lord has been taking us on this book of 2 Samuel chapter number 9. And now every time I try to preach something different, the Lord says, continue. Amen. And that is verse number 1. Now David said, is there still anyone who is left in the house of Saul that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? And last Sunday we talked about Ziba, who was a destiny helper. And the other Sunday we talked about Mephibosheth, the man that was helped. Amen. And now we talk, and there's also David, who was now asking this question. David was a man of authority. David was a king. David was in a position to help. Amen. Is there somebody this morning who is in that position to help somebody? I know we talked about destiny helpers, but have you ever thought yourself as a destiny helper to somebody? If you have never thought about it that way, I pray that this morning that the Lord will make you a destiny helper to somebody. Hallelujah. The Lord is going to move you from that level of waiting for destiny helper to be a person that's going to be there waiting for others to help them and to usher them to their destiny in Jesus' name. Amen. So when I preached about destiny helpers last Sunday, I went home and I continued to pray. And the Lord told me, now that you have taught my people about destiny helper, I want you to help them to realize how they'll be able to identify the destiny helpers when they come to their life. Because for sure they will come. Amen? For sure destiny helpers will come to your life. But the question is, how do you identify that this is a destiny helper? Amen? How do you know for sure that if somebody comes to your life that this is a destiny helper, this is not a counterfeit? Because you see what happens when the Lord releases something in the spirit, the enemy also releases something to come and counterfeit what the Lord releases. So the Lord saying, for sure he is bringing destiny helpers in your life. And remember, the destiny helpers, how they come to your life, is not only the people who are in authority. We found that there are other little people like little Mary that help Naaman to receive his healing. Now, when you are busy waiting for the manager, the Lord sees that that lady that is serving the tea there is your destiny helper. Am I speaking to somebody? Hallelujah. When you are waiting for the manager to come and help you, and you are sitting there, you cannot talk to anybody else, the Lord said that the janitor that is moving around has a word for you. See, that's your answer. And if you ignore them, you are ignoring your destiny. Praise the Lord. When you are looking for billionaires and millionaires, running after them for fame and name, the Lord sees that your destiny and your fame is hidden in that person that you leave behind and you ignore. Amen. Now, how do we know for sure who our destiny helpers? How do we embrace them? How do we receive them? Because when they come to our life, we have to embrace them, we have to receive them. Amen. How do you also connect with them? Because when you connect with your destiny helpers, they will help you to get to the level where the Lord wants you to be. Amen. Hallelujah. Let me tell you, church. The Lord was telling me that sometimes in church, we are so focused on the people who are just within you. And you forget that the Lord can bring a destiny helper from outside. A destiny helper for somebody that you do not know. And as somebody that was not even in the house of God. Remember, the Lord has said that He is even in this season. He is even channeling the world of wicked and bringing them to the people of God. But the problem is, when the world is being channeled, you don't even have an account to hold the world. When the world is being even channeled, you don't even have the mindset to handle that world. Ah, amen. And we are here this every Sunday worshiping. We are here every time speaking the word of God. But the Lord comes and brings and opens the gates of heaven and gave them everything. But we don't have the capacity to hold. So as you connect with your destiny helper, there are some things that you have to learn. And one of the things that you have to learn, you have to have a discerning spirit. You have to have a discerning spirit. Amen. What is discernment? Discernment is when you get into a room. Discernment is when you get to somebody and talk to somebody. And the Lord opens your eyes, the inner eyes, that you may have an understanding. Praise the Lord. That's a discernment. You discern what the season that we are in. You discern people that God is bringing in your life. Amen. So when you have a discernment spirit, you will never go wrong. May the Lord grant discernment spirit to all of you in this house, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Say, I receive a discerning spirit. Hallelujah.
And when you have a discerning spirit, church, even those counterfeit, even those spiritual things that comes in, those things that are not from God, you will see them from afar and you'll be able to get to your knees and cast them away in the name of Jesus. Amen. When you have a discerning spirit, you'll be able to fight things in the spirit. Amen.
The problem is when we don't have a discerning spirit, we fight in the physical. Hallelujah.
So you spend all your time, you spend all your energy fighting and fighting and fighting.
And you get tired, you get frustrated with your friends, with your enemies, because you fight everybody. But the Lord says that when you have a discerning spirit, when you see them, instead of seeing them as your enemies, you just decide that they are hurting. And then you start praying in the spirit. Amen.
Amen.
You decide that they are hurting. And somebody once said that hurting people hurt people. So when they are hurting, they are still hurting. But then, instead of fighting with them, what you do? You have a discerning spirit. And that discerning spirit will help you to fight battles in the spirit. Hallelujah.
Now, number two, something that you also need to have. You also need to have humility. Humility is the key word. You have a discerning spirit connected with humility. Humility is when we see the Bible talks about that maid that came to mama of the house and told him that, "Mama, how come Naaman? He has tried everything. He is sick. He is leprous. Why don't you take him to my prophet? Because I've seen my prophet performing miracles." And the mama of the house had humility to listen to this maid and say that, "I will act as by your word." And the thing is, when you're in the Lord, you can come to the service so distressed, you can come here to the service, even so discouraged. And the Lord uses a little kid here with a memory verse. And if you have humility, that little kid will minister to you, and that one will change your life forever. Hallelujah. That little kid can come here. Even the pastor can preach the whole night. But your heart was, your destiny changing message was with that little kid that we. So that's why it's very important for you to have a discerning spirit and have humility.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Number three, you have to have wisdom. Wisdom. Wisdom is the key thing. Wisdom is the key thing. And let me say it clearly here, church. Wisdom does not come with age. Praise the Lord. Somebody will say, Pastor, why are you talking about it? Why are you talking that? Because I know people who are aged and they are behind bars. Amen. I know child molesters that are old and they are behind bars. Amen. So wisdom does not come with age. I know godly men that are behind bars. Amen. And they are aged. So wisdom does not come with age. But wisdom comes from the Lord, and the Lord himself can grant you wisdom. Hallelujah. And that's why Solomon prayed, and he was asked by God what he wanted, and Solomon said, all I need is wisdom. And he was told that you have asked for something that is noble, because with wisdom you have wealth. With wisdom we have power to manage people. Hallelujah. So may the Lord grant you, each and everyone in this house, a level of wisdom like none other, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Somebody say, I receive it in Jesus' name. Amen. So number one, you have to understand that wisdom comes from God, because he's the author of every wisdom. Amen. So when you connect with God, you have wisdom to do things. Amen. And do not confuse understanding, knowledge, and wisdom. Amen. Where does knowledge come from? Knowledge comes from books. Knowledge comes from when you go to school, you receive knowledge. You study. I've seen educated people who do not have wisdom. So you have knowledge. And knowledge is good. We need to add knowledge in our life, because knowledge adds value to us. Amen. When you have knowledge, then you have understanding. What is understanding? Understanding is when you get that knowledge that you have, and you understand the principles behind why things happen. Amen. You may have a knowledge that you see an airplane going to the sky. But when you have an understanding, you have an understanding of what goes on, the power that takes that airplane from the ground to the sky. That's understanding. Amen. And not everybody have that kind of understanding. Amen. We have our brother Ben. He's a pilot. Amen. He has that understanding. Praise the Lord. So he knows how the power of the plane of taking off, and he has an understanding of it. Praise the Lord. Now, wisdom. This is the key word. It comes from the Lord. And wisdom is the goodness. You get the knowledge, you have the understanding, and you have that ability to apply it in your own life. Then you have wisdom in Jesus' name. Amen. And when you have that one, that's the only thing that you can sit and start and say, I will never settle for less, because I know there's more that is in the Lord. Amen. When you watch news and you see other discouraging things, instead of switching to the depression mode, you come to God and say, I will never settle for this. Praise the Lord. When you talk to your friends and everything they are telling you is discouraging news, you go back to the Lord and say, I have a wisdom that comes from God. Amen. And something else that you need to understand, so that you can understand the destiny helpers, we also need the grace of God. Amen. We need the grace of God. And grace is unmerited favor that comes from God. Unmerited favor that comes from God. Meaning you don't have to work for it. You don't have to earn it. It's given freely from God. But you have to position yourself to receive the grace of God. Amen. So we need the grace of God every day. We need the amazing grace of God to be poured in our life. It is the amazing grace of God that helps us to preach. It is the amazing grace of God that helps you to learn your family. It is the amazing grace of God that even helps you to wake up and come to the house.
house of God.
It is the amazing grace of God that helps you to love people that dishonor you and people who do not like you. It is the grace of God. It is the grace of God that keeps you moving, even when the world is falling apart. It is the grace of God that gives you that peace when everything is shutting down. It is the grace of God. It's nothing by the grace of God. Amen. Somebody say, God, I need your grace. Amazing grace. Hallelujah. Just, you don't just call for grace. You call for grace and you say, I need amazing grace. Amen. And it's amazing. Amen. Is it something amazing? Is something that you cannot be able to describe. Amen. One time I took my kids to a basketball game and they were watching everything that was happening. And then when I asked them, how was the game? They said, it was amazing. So when I was trying to understand, what were they talking about? They were trying to tell me, Dad, that whatever you brought, whatever you showed us, or whatever you have given us, we don't have words to explain it. Amen. Is there somebody this morning that when you look at your life, when you look at what the Lord has done for you, the only thing that you can say is, Lord, you are amazing. Amen. So somebody say amazing grace.
Amazing grace.
Hallelujah. And you know the song about the amazing grace. Hallelujah. And now, the Bible says in the book of John, chapter number 1 and verse 17. And this is very important for you to understand. That Moses, the law was given through Moses. But grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Law was given by Moses, but grace and truth come through Jesus Christ. So what another thing that you need to do for you to discover your destiny helpers, you need to discover the truth. Amen. And this is where, let me explain something here, church. Amen. You need to understand the truth. That word truth is not just a word that you just come and pops in the Bible. I told you that law came through Moses, but grace and truth come through Jesus Christ. Grace and truth come through Jesus Christ. So when Jesus stepped into this world, what he brought the grace that I asked you when we prayed about. And now there's something that called the truth. And the Bible says that you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Somebody say amen. Somebody shout, I'm free. I am free. I am free in Jesus' name. Because the Bible says that you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. So Jesus came with freedom. Jesus brought the captive free. So when you are in Jesus, it means that now you have that grace and you have the truth in you. And when you have the truth in Jesus Christ, then you'll be able to discern and to know when destiny helpers are coming to your life. Amen. Somebody say truth. And the truth come in Jesus Christ. Amen. Truth come in Jesus Christ. Truth come in Jesus Christ. He brought the truth to the world. And now, when I speak the word truth, church, because I'm teaching today, the truth, there's one word that comes opposite of the truth when you talk about in the Bible in the spiritual realm. And that word is called stronghold. Stronghold. So when you see stronghold in the Bible and you see truth on this other side, those two parts are opposite. Amen. The truth is in Jesus Christ. A stronghold, the definition of the word stronghold, is the lie that we believe. Amen. That's the definition of the word stronghold. That lie that you believe is a stronghold. And I pray that this morning every foundation that of lies that you've been believing will be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Strongholds. Things that hold you down. Things that anchors your life that are not from God. Those are strongholds. And we destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody give God praise this morning.
Hallelujah. Yes, I think we are more than that.
Can somebody give God the highest praise in this house this morning? Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Hallelujah. So that means when you know the truth, it destroys every stronghold in your life. It destroys every stronghold in your life.